Monsters, Inc. is one of my personal favorite films. Not just Pixar films, but personal favorite films. Pixar has brought us some amazing movies over the years, but none of them have touched me quite as deeply as Monsters, Inc. It has memorable characters. It has a rather fun story. It presents an interesting world of monsters. It has some highly quotable bits of comedy throughout the film. And it has become the kind of movie that I enjoy more and more with each viewing. But even with all these good points, I believe that the greatest strength in this film has to do with the relationship between Sully and Boo. And that is what I specifically want to talk about today. James P. Sullivan and Mike Wazowski have been working together at Monsters, Inc. for many years, becoming the best of the best in the business. Sully and Mike have spent their lives working towards breaking the all-time scare record, and Sully spends much of his waking hours achieving that goal. He is happy with all that he has accomplished, and looks forward to the day when he can go down in the history books for breaking the record. But all of that changes when he accidentally allows a child to come into the monster world. At first, Sully is terrified of this little girl, and with good reason. He has been taught all his life that children are toxic, and that a single touch could kill him. Sully is desperate to try and return this little girl back to her own world, and keeps running into trouble all along the way. But the more time he spends with this little girl, the more he starts to realize that maybe children aren't so dangerous. And he starts to enjoy spending time with her, even to the point of naming her Boo. He still wants to send her back to where she belongs, but he also starts to care for her well-being, wanting to keep her safe and happy. And we also see the lengths that he will go to in order to keep her safe. It creates a very touching scene at the end when we can see just how much Sully has come to care for this little girl, and how much it pains him to let her go. But even without Boo in his life, we can also see just how much more he has made of himself, how Sully had become an effective leader because of the inspiration that this little girl had given him. Sully had spent so much of his life working towards breaking the all-time scare record, and when Boo enters his life, he reaches a point where he decides that that one goal that he has been working for suddenly isn't so important, all because of this little girl that he wants to keep safe. The whole of the monster world has taught everyone to fear children, to stay away from them at all costs. Sully came to realize that everything he has been taught about children might be wrong. He is able to see for himself how much his priorities change because of that realization. And we see how much more he was able to make of himself because of what he learned from Boo. Now, I would like to ask each of you a question. Does anything about Sully's journey sound familiar to you? When I was thinking about Monsters, Inc., I began to notice how much Sullivan's journey compares to my own. I was living my life as best as I could make of it, believing that the goals I was striving for were worthwhile. And I remembered how the world had taught me direct rules about what I should be looking for in life, and what I should be avoiding. This is something that had been ingrained into me at a very early age. And I found myself reaching a point where something came into my life and I wasn't sure what to think of it at first. I even had a little worry over it back then. The thought of enjoying a cartoon show about pink ponies was just so foreign to me. Until I came to realize that what the world had taught me wasn't necessarily true. But I had to be willing to put aside my fears and decide what was important to me. And when I started to enjoy MLP and the Brony fandom that surrounds it, I began to notice my priorities beginning to change. I started to feel inspired by the characters I was watching, and even stories from other Bronies within the fandom. I was putting aside some of the things that I had been taught to avoid, and I began to feel a sense of camaraderie. And how I've gained so much of an appreciation for something that seems so foreign to me. And even how I have felt inspired by it, living a better life because of it. And now I've reached a point in my life where I am helping others to find a greater appreciation and even inspiration from MLP. And I'm doing things that I never would have thought that I was capable of doing. I'm reaching out to people when I had spent so much of my life trying not to be noticed. And I still feel as though I am only scratching the surface of what I can accomplish. And when I take a look at Monsters, Inc., I began to realize that I've always enjoyed watching what is cute, adorable, and sweet. And that is a lot of what MLP is about, too. But I still had to put aside my hesitations in order to find everything else that MLP had to offer. Much like with Sully discovering that his goal of becoming the top scarer wasn't the most that he could become, He ended up being inspired by the little girl who he had grown to care for and became an effective leader. It's amazing what one can accomplish when they can stop focusing so much on a single goal and think about what else they can contribute to the world. And I am learning more about that very thing, each and every day. You never know how much you are capable of until you try. I am grateful for discovering both MLP and the Brony fandom. They have helped me to break out of the stigma of believing that I already knew everything that I could accomplish. And I sincerely hope that each of you will take a moment and think about your own journeys. Why you began to enjoy a show like MLP. Why you started taking part in the Brony fandom. Do you believe that you have become a better person because you were willing to put aside your hesitations? I would like to hear your thoughts about the journeys you have taken to get where you are now, and perhaps we can continue to help others find their own way. I am Dr. Wolf, and I look forward to hearing from you. Oh yes, there was one more thing that I wanted to add today. DavionXY, who did the art for my avatar and my channel page, had recently sent me another image that I thought turned out so well that I wanted to use it on this video. I've paired it along with some lovely music from my favorite scene in Monsters, Inc. I hope you enjoy it.